Disclaimer: this video is strictly for educational purposes and should not be used as medical or diagnostic advice. If you suspect that you or someone you know is experiencing hemispatial neglect syndrome, please contact your nearest healthcare provider.
Ever since having a stroke, things have been a bit weird. I have trouble finding things even if they're right in front of me. It's only been taking half as long to get ready, but sometimes my friends let me know that I forgot to put my makeup on both sides of my face. It's probably not a big deal though, right? My family and friends have been saying that I seem different, but you know, I think they're probably overreacting, but I will be going to the doctor's office today, just in case. Why am I still so hungry? I've eaten my entire plate, but it feels like I've eaten maybe half. At the doctor's office, we discussed symptoms and my prior stroke on the right side. After that, they had me do some drawing tests. The letter identification test, where I had to circle all of the A's on the page that I could see. Then, the line bisection test. I just marked the middle of the line that was given to me on the page. I did a few more tests after this, the copy drawing test and something called the clock test. I think they figured out what's up though. Apparently, all of my drawings are unfinished and pushed to the right side. I didn't really realize this though, they looked fine to me. During my diagnosis, the doctor showed me these infographics to explain what was going on.
After looking at the test results, it seems that you may have a condition called hemispatial neglect syndrome. Do you know much about this? It's a condition where an individual is unable to pay attention to one side of their environment. It's caused by damage to one side of the parietal lobe. Usually the person's vision and senses are fine. It's not that they can't see or feel, they just don't notice the neglected side. Most people affected by this condition experience damage to the right side of the brain and therefore cannot perceive the left side of their environment. This is because the left parietal lobe attends to the right side of the environment, while the right parietal lobe attends to both the right and left side of the environment. When the right side is damaged, the left side of the environment isn't attended to. On the bright side, there are two different therapies that we can explore to help treat this. The first is known as prism adaptation theory. Essentially, you wear prism glasses that shift your view horizontally, towards the side that you neglect. You'll be tasked to pick up or move objects. However, due to the shift of view, you'll end up missing. Your brain will quickly learn to accommodate this shift, however, and you get better oriented. After taking off the glasses, your brain retains some of this learning and helps you better attend to stimuli in the neglected environment. Another option is limb activation occupational therapy. In this treatment, you will be asked to use limbs on your non-neglected side and move them around on the side that is neglected. For example, if you have a lesion in the right parietal lobe, you will neglect the left side. You'll use your right limbs in the left environment. This is shown to help rewire the brain and get it to attend to the neglected side.
Now, when I have trouble finding something right in front of me, the doctor taught me to do something called scanning therapy, where I scan my entire environment, kind of moving my head like a lighthouse. It seems silly, but this way I've been losing things a lot less often. It's been difficult for me to understand hemispatial neglect because it's not like blindness. Nothing's wrong with my eyes, I just don't pay attention to an entire half of my world. I've also been bumping into everything with my left side lately. I think that's another symptom the doctor may have mentioned though. Strangely enough, I've also been having trouble remembering things correctly. Since hemispatial neglect is an attentional problem and not sensory, it extends to imagination and memory too. Even reading doesn't really make sense anymore. I can't understand what it is that I'm reading, even though this used to be one of my favorite books. Although there's a relatively low success rate for treatment, I do hope it works. The doctor did tell me that treatment may prevent more severe symptoms from developing and improve my overall symptoms.
While the prevalence of hemispatial neglect is not extensively researched, some sources estimate its incidence to be as high as 82% among post-stroke patients. In the US, although left hemisphere strokes occur more frequently than right hemisphere strokes, at 54% versus 46%, spatial neglect disproportionately follows right-sided strokes. Hemispatial neglect is strongly associated with older age, lower socioeconomic status, and white race.
It is important to note that hemispatial neglect is tricky to illustrate in a point of view format. While the blurriness and inattention are clear to viewers and a third party, patients experiencing hemispatial neglect syndrome typically do not even realize there is a deficit because it is not brought to their conscious attention.